So I rarely get super excited about trees. Well, that's a lie. You've seen my channel. I often get really excited about trees. But this morning I'm particularly excited because look at these massive oaks here. So I've come to Jespris Deer Park, which is located just north of Copenhagen. And it's probably our most famous deer park here in Denmark. And it is a place where there's a castle in the middle where the royals came and then they hunted the deers in this garden. And it's a massive area. It's this very old area. And as you can see on these oak trees here are like more than 500 years old, which is very, very rare to have that in Denmark. In the area I come from over in Jutland, I'm in Zealand now, we almost have none left of those very, very, very old oak trees. There are a few standing around here and there, but nothing close to the collection we have in this huge deer park right here. And again, just north of Copenhagen. So it's very easy to find, it's very easy to get into. It is full of trails. There are runners, horseback riders, and deers just roaming around freely. So I know a lot of wildlife photographers love to come here. But I'm here obviously as a landscape photographer, and I don't mind integrating animals, as I said in last week's video, into my videos. So hopefully maybe I can have a deer underneath a tree or something like that. Right now the light is absolutely flat and boring. I was promised more, and hopefully the sun will come out at some point. But until then, I can just walk around, scout around, find some compositions. I've already found a lot, just need a little bit better light. But enough contextualizing. Today's video is all about whether you need a tripod for landscape photography. Because you often see me use one of these three-legged things, which is a brand, this is a Benro. And for the most part, I personally use a tripod. It is very, very handy for me to use a tripod because I can use my little DJI Osmo Pocket to film myself. And then I can simply just turn that one around and show you my setup. So microphone on the camera is just for B-roll when I film myself. And I just show you the back of the screen here. That would be really, really hard if I was to use my hand to hold the camera at the same time. So that is why I find a tripod to be very, very handy to the kind of landscape photography that I do. So this particular composition right here, you can see I have some branches sticking up. I have the sun coming out just before, I'm going to show you here. I just had some birds fly by. But what I was attracted to was these, I think it's crows, sitting here on top of these, well, very gnarly dead branches. And I think it's such a moody photo, very, very isolated. Very, very, yeah, well, you can almost hear the photo somehow. So that was what I was photographing here. As you can see, I also have put on the long lens, 100-400. I'm all the way out at 300 millimeter, maybe 400 millimeter. And when you're shooting with such a long lens, something very, very far away, it's often also a good idea to use a tripod. However, since I'm basically shooting directly right now into the sun rise, and I'm shooting at like f8, I put it up to ISO 200, but I could probably put it down to ISO 100 because I have a shutter speed of 1/1000th of a second. So I should easily be able to handhold the shot because there's just so much light. So in this particular case, no, I would not need a tripod, especially not if I also have image stabilization on, because there's simply just so much light. But I'm using it because I'm showing you what I'm doing. So the light still isn't particularly interesting because of some high clouds. But the good thing about high clouds is that there is a chance of getting a sun halo. And that's exactly what I'm having right now. It's not the strongest sun halo in the entire world, that's for sure. But there is a little bit going on here, as you can see. And as you can also see, I found probably the most obvious composition I can find right here. I've just found one of those old, beautiful oak trees and placed it right underneath the halo. I am also using my tripod for this particular shot here, even though I again am shooting directly into the sun. Exactly because I'm shooting directly into the sun, I have chosen to bracket this photo. So I'm taking one photo with a normal exposure, then I'm taking one two stops above and two stops below, so I have the entire dynamic range. Will I need to use all three brackets? Probably not. I have experienced that my camera here, the A7R III, has a really good dynamic range, so I'll probably not need all three brackets, but now I have them. But the thing is, when you make several photos or brackets, whether you're only making two, one for the highlights, one for the shadows, or you're making three or five and so on, it's a good idea to keep the camera completely still. And that is where a tripod is very, very handy. On top of that, when I'm shooting at f16, again, I don't have a whole lot of light, even though I'm basically shooting directly into the light. I am, with my middle exposure, only having a shutter speed of 1/25th of a second. So that is where a tripod, again, comes in to be very, very handy. Can you handhold a bracket photo? Yes, you can. But optimally, you would want to have it on a tripod so the camera doesn't move in between the brackets. Even the slightest movement, well, Photoshop can handle it for the most part, but it's just so annoying to put it together when you're using luminosity masks. So therefore, I would definitely suggest to use a tripod when you bracket your photos and you want to use luminosity masking, which is something I also talk about in my huge Photoshop course, Photoshop for Landscape Photographers from Beginner to Advanced. So if you want to learn a whole lot about how I edit my photos, be sure to check out the coupon code down in the description to get a little bit off, 15%. And yeah, that's it. Tripod, bracketing, good idea. So another place where it's a good idea to use a tripod is when you focus stack. So focus stacking simply just means that you take one photo where the background is in focus, and usually when you focus on a background, then the foreground has a tendency to fall out of focus, and then you take a photo for the foreground also, and then you combine those two, three, four, five photos, depending on how many you need to get the full depth of field, you combine those in Photoshop. Sometimes you use Photoshop, other times you use third-party plugins. I'm not going to show you exactly how to combine them in this video, but I'll show it in my big Photoshop course. However, I'm going to show you how I do it in the field with the tripod. So, I have this really cool tree here in the background. I have the sun over here, so it's not necessarily completely optimal. However, I do have some pretty nice clouds up here right now, and I think they can work as a background and hopefully also can give a little bit of drama with the sun coming up here. I have found this fallen over log, I think you would call it in English, and I'm using that as the foreground. You can see I have a little bend right here in the log, and that is what I'm trying to include in the photo. As you can see here, down here is the foreground. So I'm going to shoot the log with one photo or maybe two to focus stack it, and then I'm making one for the background with the tree. So you can see the tree is right there. Nice central composition. And then the log is supposed to like frame the tree and give a little bit of like depth and foreground interest to this really cool background here. I actually think this could be quite a cool photo from what I can see right now. Like, oh wow, I'm so white. But I also have the sun straight in my face. But yeah, so when you focus stack, it's a good idea to use a tripod because you again want to keep the camera still. So those are the things that you need to consider whether or not to use a tripod. Is it for practical purposes like I do, so I can show you guys it? Or is it because you simply don't have enough light, you have a slow shutter speed, so you want to keep the camera still as to get a sharp photo? That is like the main purpose of the tripod. But then there's also if you want to like focus stack, or if you want to bracket your photos. Those are the places where you would usually try to use a tripod because it's just so much easier. It's so much less of a hassle to use a tripod, even though it can be a little bit of a hassle putting up a tripod. But those are the places where I personally would use a tripod. Oh boy, like this location, this deer park here is just like so full of potential. So many old characteristic trees with just like so much history in them. Like over here, a stump. I just passed an area in here which is like very swamp-ish, but very beautiful. Right now I have found this composition right here with this tree. And you can see it better here on the back of my screen. So the sun has finally really come out. Long lens on, backlit vegetation, and it just looks so beautiful. Again, I'm using the tripod. I'm all the way down at 1/3 of a second for this composition, ISO 100, and I'm all the way up at, it's probably going to be f22 with this one. The thing is, f22 is actually not the smallest aperture the 100 to 400 millimeter lens can do. It can go all the way up to f40, but that is just like one big blur. So yeah, no reason to do that. F22 may work, else I'll go F16. But it's simply just to get as many trees in the scene in focus as possible without having to focus stack. Because in this particular case, focus stacking would be a nightmare. There's simply just too many details overlapping throughout the scene. But yeah, beautiful, beautiful photo this one. So I'm obviously also using a tripod around water, and that is for the long exposures. Like obviously you want to make a long exposure, so you need to make sure that you have a tripod and keep the camera still. Tripod is usually also really good if you want to make video, so you're not making those crazy handheld videos. But yeah, besides that, It's always interesting when you come out to a new location and the weather is a little bit like bland. I hope I've got some good photos today. I think I did. But it wasn't before the last one here that I actually got a photo where I'm like, yeah, I can see in the field that there's potential in this photo. It's probably going to be really good. So if you want to learn more about composition in landscape photography, be sure to get my two eBooks. Here I go through all the many different compositional tools, I call them, that you can use in the field as to compose your photos more optimally and make them really, really pretty. People tend to like these eBooks. There are lots of 5-star reviews, and as per always, a huge thank you to all of you who have already got them. If you haven't been in, giving them a 5-star review, I would highly appreciate it. And yeah, let's just end on a high note here with a good photo. And yeah, next week, hopefully, I'll make a video from the Faroe Islands. I have a couple of workshops up there I'm running with Nick Page. So yeah, you can look forward to those. Check out all the links in the description. My Photoshop course, my extension, photography maps for Iceland and Faroe Islands if you're going there. Everything, yeah. All the details down there or on my homepage. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram. I'm doing so much. These outros are getting longer and longer. Thank you so much for watching. All the details in the description. Bye, 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 bye.